DC representing KitchenAid. She's also the Pillsbury 2012 National Recipe Champion. Girl knows her way around the kitchen. Yes, she does. Good to have you back, my friend.
Hello.
I'm going to sneak up here and grab this information card.
Yes.
And we're talking about an attachment that fits on any KitchenAid stand mixer ever made.
That's right.
In the 100, almost 1 years you've been in business.
Mm-hmm. No matter what age, no matter what model, it's going to work with them all. So this is a baking tool, an attachment that's going to go right on your stand mixer, and it's going to do three things. It's going to weigh your dry ingredients, it's going to sift your dry ingredients, and it's going to shoot them into the bowl.
Wow.
Which is fabulous. So
now, I have only 2,700 of these to go around. We don't have many left to go around at all. It's $126.64 at retail. We're $38.66 less tonight.
Wow.
Now, the reason we need this attachment is because, as you well know, Pillsbury National Recipe Champion, the baking is an exact science.
It is. And we've all had a baking blunder. You know, I have had a baking blunder. David's had a
baking blunder.
We've all had them. And sometimes it might be because we're not exact enough in measuring our ingredients. If we take a look down here, and this is actually the weighing part, the scale part of the unit, and you can use it as a standalone scale. Let's say that you were never taught how to measure your flour, so you just jam pack as much as you can.
More has to be better, right?
Mm-hmm. Okay. So that one is 239 grams. Let's say you spoon it in and you level it off. That's maybe how we learned in home ec class. So that one is 232 grams. Let's say you're in a hurry, so you scoop against the side of the container and kind of scrape it up as it goes back. And that one is 225 grams. So you can have up to a 16% difference, even though it all looks like one cup of flour.
And we've got some pictures of what that difference can do to, say, a loaf of bread. Take a look here.
So here's a loaf of bread. You can see the one on the left there, 144 grams of flour. That's too much flour, and it weighed down the loaf. 124, that's actually how much one cup of flour is supposed to be, and the yeast was able to do its work and make a beautiful fluffy loaf of bread. Now this unit also sifts. Why should I bother with sifting? Take a look at the non-sifted. It's denser, it's squattier. You can even see some little pebbles of dry ingredients that did not get mixed in, whereas the sifted model is fluffy and light and perfect.
Now, I will tell you that we've got a great savings for you tonight. We're saving you $38.66. You're going to get the scale, you're getting the sifter, you're getting all of the attachment. This will work on any KitchenAid stand. Okay, you've got great grandma's stand mixer from 1941.
That's right.
It'll work.
It will definitely work for sure. And it's so simple to use. Three easy parts that you're going to assemble. So here you're just going to plug in this part into your stand mixer power hub. Here is that scale part. This is going to come with batteries already built in. You have two double A's in here. This is your 4-cup hopper. So three simple parts. Notice the chute here. When you get it home, it's going to be tucked up inside. If you just pull down, it extends. So I can use it in a bowl outside the bowl, or it swivels and fits into any one of your mixer bowls. Up here, the hopper has a valve in it. This is what releases the ingredients
into the
sifting mechanism. Right. And here is where you turn on the scale part. So it has a power button. It has a tear button that takes it back to zero, so you can measure part of your dry ingredients. Let's put in some powdered sugar here. It's going to measure in grams, ounces, and pounds.
It's a little hard to see that scale on camera, but we can look here, and it says 111 grams of powdered sugar.
Right. So if your recipe calls for that, you just add enough for what your recipe calls for. Then if I want to add another ingredient, I press that tear to take it back to zero. Let's say I want to add some cocoa powder next. Add as much as the recipe calls for.
I'm noticing also you can change it from grams to ounces to pounds.
Right.
So if you're like me and don't have any idea how much 111 grams is,
right.
I put a gun to my head, I couldn't tell you. Press the button and it'll do it. Or you can ask Alexa. Yeah. This is, I ask her a lot of things when I'm cooking. Sometimes I ask her to tell me a joke. Sometimes I ask her to run to the wine store and get me a bottle. She doesn't do that.
There you go. So now I just turn on my stand mixer. That's what powers the unit. So if you want it to come out more slowly or more fast, you would just adjust the speed on your unit. And look how light and fluffy the ingredients are. Let's take a look inside. It's fun to see the sifter working as well. So this is inside the sifter unit. There is a fine mesh screen and a little wire that moves back and forth.
Right.
To sift those dry ingredients. It's never going to hurt to sift.
I was going to say, why do you think it helps?
Because it aerates, it removes all those little lumps so that the ingredients can mix better, and you're going to get
smoothly.
Those fluffy, delicious, wonderful fluffy.
You get more cakes. Of a velvety batter, I would assume,
mm-hmm.
with cakes and cookies and cupcakes, or not cookies so much, but cupcakes.
Right.
And
you can see how lumpy the little bits are behind, so it's really going to help to sift through those.
Break them up.
Exactly.
Hey, can I tell you that we've now taken orders for 200 of these. This is a sale price. You should also know that this is all part of our KitchenAid month, which is lasting through March 22nd, which is why you want to get yours now while the getting is good. We're very, very excited to be able to bring this to you tonight at a savings of over $38. And this will work on every KitchenAid stand mixer ever made, even the very first one back in 1919.
That's right.
If we went into the archives at KitchenAid and pulled it out of the museum and plugged it in, it would work. That power hub hasn't changed in over 100 years. Tina Varelli, we're all off on Sunday.
Oh, my goodness.
It's Fashion Day.
Oh, we should all go to brunch together.
We should all go to brunch.